弟兄姐妹，大家早上好。
Morning, brothers and sisters.
你们睡了吗
？Have you guys slept?
帮我一下，捏一捏你身边的人啊，没事给他醒一下，捏一下他，捏他一下。
Can you help me? You know, pinch the people next to you, get them to wake up. You know, give them a massage, give them a good shoulder massage.
那我很喜欢刚刚我们的 Brother Jimmy 他所讲出的这今年的五大主题跟健康有关系。
So I am really, really grateful and very happy that Brother Jimmy just now shared something very important, which is our five expect themes that we are covering this year.
我真的发觉健康对这个世代的人来说真的是很缺欠的。
So because I believe, right, health, this thing,is very lacking in today's generation.
所以问问你身边的人，你健康吗
？So ask the person next to you, you healthy 啊 ？Are you healthy？
所以你再问他，你看看，你觉得我健康吗
？So then you ask them, do you think I'm healthy？
好，非常兴奋，再次能够跟大家分享神的话。
I'm very, very happy, you know, to be able to stand in front of all of you here to deliver God's word.
盼望今天的信息能够祝福大家。
So I hope that today's message will be able to bless all of you today.
刚刚Brother Jimmy 看到我说，哇，很凶哦，你今天的主题。
So then, just now Brother Jimmy, you know, we met and he saw me and said, wow, brother, today your sermon very fierce 啊。
是，很凶，真的很凶，谋杀关系。好。
So it's very, you know, murder relationship.
让我们先来做祷告，好吧？
So let's do a prayer.
亲爱的主，我们满心的感谢你，让我们有机会来到当中团契。
God, we pray to you and thank you, Lord, for the privilege to be able to come before you here to worship you.
感谢你，我们还有生命的气息，能够分享，也能够聆听。
Thank you for giving us that we still have the breath of life to be able to share and also to receive your word.
主啊，我们求你今天的灵运行在我们每一个人的当中，包括我自己。
I pray, Lord, that Your Holy Spirit be among us, fill every one of us, including me.
让讲的和听的都得建立蒙福。
And I pray that the one who shares and also the one who listens may be edified and be blessed.
我们这样的祈求祷告，奉耶稣的名。
With this we pray, in name of Jesus Christ we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 好，今天当看到那么强烈的主题的时候，你们第一个画面出现的会是什么呢
？So after seeing such a very aggressive kind of title, what comes to your mind when you see this?
谋杀关系耶
，murder relationship. What do you think?
当我自己取这个主题的时候，立刻出现在我的头脑的画面就是这个。
So when I was making this sermon, the first thing that came to my mind was this.
就是惊天动地的一个新闻，在香港，就是蔡天凤这个名媛被谋杀。
So this was a very recent and gruesome news about the murder of Hong Kong model Abby Choi.
相信大家都知道，对不对
？I think some of you might have heard about this, right?
而且那一个的消息越传越发现越多的时候，我们会觉得哇，真的人心难测，太恐怖了。
So because as we continue going deep diving, delving further into the news and information that keeps coming up, we kind of find it, wow, this is creepy and yet also so gruesome.
因为谋杀这个蔡天凤的是他的前夫嘛，我们开始打听的是前夫。
So at first, you know what, because what we heard earlier, you know, the one responsible for the murder is her ex-husband.
So 接着下来，原来他前夫的爸爸妈妈还有哥哥也在当中 ，Wow!
And it found out after that, after much investigation, that not only the ex-husband, but the in-laws, which is the ex-husband's mother, father, and older brother, are also involved in this.
当然，接着下来呢，有更多的新闻讲到，可能现任丈夫也涉及在里面。哇，好混乱哦！现任的丈夫。
Oh, it could be also some further news controversy has spread out that her current spouse is the one.That is causing and is behind this as well. So
有消息指出说，现任丈夫和她之前前任丈夫是情侣来的哦。
And also more controversies stated up that the ex-husband and current husband are lovers.
好乱哦。
So this is so complex.
听说现在又有消息说，她的前夫跟她的妈妈。感情又好像有感情的，很奇怪。
And it's also very weird because more controversies have spread up saying that the current husband and the mother also is kind of embroiled in some sort of affair.
重点是回到来那么混乱当中，我们看到蔡天凤 被很残忍的残杀，而且是非常有计划的谋杀。
And in the midst of this, we see how gruesome, but also at the same time organized her murder was.
当这个蔡天凤的消息出来之后呢，接下来在 Facebook 你会看到有很多以前的旧账那些新闻啊，关于谋杀的啊，夫妻谋杀的，就开始刊登出来了。
So as you saw this on Facebook, a lot of previous news, you mean? Previous news of this kind of murders and all of that have arisen again.
有其中一则经文呢，吸引了我的眼球。
So a previous news of murder case has gotten my attention.
他就是有一个男子哈，他把他的妻子杀了之后，分尸之后，把他的肉碎搅碎了之后呢，用马桶冲掉。
So this kind of news, one of them that you know particularly caught my eye was this one was a husband who killed his wife, you know, grind her entire body in a meat grinder, minced meat, and flush it all down the toilet.
而且之后他很厉害，他还杀了他妻子之后，他还是在弄了一个寻人启事，演起戏来了。他说他的太太不见了，他在寻什么？在寻回他的太太，叫人帮忙。
So he and somehow one thing was crazy was that he created a fake alibi for himself, and then he says that his wife has gone missing. He makes a police report saying that he's looking for his missing wife.
到最后被抓了之后，人开始访问他、盘问他的时候，他说其实他是很爱他的妻子，同一个时候他也非常恨他的妻子。
So after being caught red-handed in this and after being interrogated, he revealed that he loved his wife very much and also hated his wife very much.
他跟他的妻子为什么会动了杀念，是因为他的妻子常常用言语去有言语的暴力去虐待他。
So the revealed reason for this was because that his wife continually used verbal abuse to abuse him.
常常说他是一个没有用的男人。
Constantly calling him a useless man.
到最后在没有通知他的底下呢，把他们的屋子的那一个产业权呢转向他自己，把他的名给删掉了。
And also this the wife who was murdered before that, before she was murdered, she changed the ownership title of their house and landing deed to her name only and cutting his name out.
这件事情引起了他极度的不满，到最后他就起了杀机。
So all of this piled up into his dissatisfaction, and he decided to take action on it.
Wow. 那当然，今天我没有想要跟你们谈关于谋杀这个东西哦。
So of course today I'm not here to talk to you about murders.
今天想谈的是谋杀关系。
But today what we're really talking about is murdering relationships.
不是谋杀身体啊。
Not murdering the body.
或者生命哦。
Or life.
我们要看一下，其实这一些的婚姻出了一些问题。当然到最后这是非常极致、非常极端的结果。
So of course we know that, you know, through the relationship, the marriage, it come off have a lot of problems and finally ended up having this outcome.
这种案件我相信在我们日常生活里面不会很多的。
But of course, you know, in these kind of extreme cases, it's not really common in our day-to-day living.
不过呢，关系上的死亡或婚姻上的死亡在我们这个世代却非常的普遍。
But the death of relationships, the death of marriage,is very, very common in this era.
你知道各国的离婚率，这个我拿到的一个在网上搜索到的一个报告是2018年的一个报告。
So, this is a statistics that I got in 2018 about the divorce statistics of different countries.
那中国离婚率38%。
The divorce rate of the entire China is 38%.
我搜索了一下，在2023年最新的报告，中国是58%，又再起了。
So, but I've checked recently this year statistics. China's divorce rates have gone up from 38% to 50% this year.
乌克兰很多美女的，听说42%。
So Ukraine, a place with a lot of beautiful ladies,
俄罗斯也是。
Russia as well.
51%哦。
51%。
美国53%离婚率。
America 53%。
瑞典，66%。
Sweden, 66%.
之后马尔代夫人家觉得最浪漫的海岛竟然离婚率是88%，还要去吗？
Maldives, the place, the home to beautiful beach and romantic scenescapes, 80%.
换句话说，有十对人结婚，八对人会离婚，你还相信婚姻吗？
So means that if 10 people get married, 8 of them are getting divorced. Do you still believe in marriage?
我想问问大家，有多少人到今天为止还相信婚姻的？举手一下。
I just want to ask a raise of hands, people who still believe in marriage, raise up your hands.
举得好勉强哦。
Wow, the, you raise it up very, very reluctantly, huh?
不举没有罪的，懂吗？我要你真实的感受。你看，我们就连我们最近一直在 Facebook 在新闻上都看到的，我们的大豆杨子琼。
So furthermore, even in newscast and media, we see a lot recently, 大豆 Michelle Yeoh.
女人的骄傲。
Wow, the pride of women.
对不对？还有我们我国的国宝。
And also a representative of.
她不是香港人啊， oh, 不是中国的哈，她是马来西亚的。
She's not from Hong Kong or from China. She's from Malaysia. Just saying.
我不知道你们有多少人知道，其实杨紫琼她有过三段婚姻。
So I don't know whether you guys know about this, but Michelle Yeoh previously had 3 marriages.
为什么现在的婚姻那么破碎？
Why are marriages right now so fragile?
今天我们要来看一看这个事情。
So now we really want to delve deep into this.
Now, 每一段的婚姻或关系的结束，很多人觉得说，我也不想的，那是自然发生的。
So a lot of relationships, when they end, when we ask those people like, hey, how did it end? What made it end? A lot of people said, I don't know, it just naturally happened and we drifted apart.
不过是真的那么自然吗？
But is it really that natural?
他有一句话是这样说，他说， relationship never dies a natural death. They are murdered by ego, attitude, and ignorance. 一段关系从来不会自然死亡。他说，他们是被骄傲和冷漠给谋杀了。那，所以换句话说，今天我们回去看我们自己的婚姻关系的时候，
So to put it into perspective, to when we look at our own relationships,
当我们的婚姻关系开始走下坡，开始冷淡的时候，
So when the marriage actually starts to go downhill and cold.
它不是自然发生,
it's not something that naturally happens.
它是我们蓄意导致的,
it is something that we ourselves are responsible for incrementally causing the downfall of it.
不过很多人可能心里会想, 不是耶, 不是蓄意的, 我也不想的, 就是这样自然发生的。
A lot of people would argue saying that, no, this is not my intention, or you're doing this step by step, it just naturally happened.
那今天我想问一下大家，
So today I want to ask you guys,
你是否在谋杀着你的婚姻？
Are you murdering your marriages or relationships right now?
你是否谋杀着你的关系？
Are you murdering your relationships now?
那今天的这一场道呢， 我想达到三个的目的。
So through this sermon, I want to be able to achieve 3 things.
第一个，希望让我们在场的夫妻们 或者有这个情侣的关系，去思考一下，去看一下，在你关系里面的一些盲点。So
I want to be able to open the eyes to couples here, may whether you're in a marriage or whether you're not in a marriage yet, to open up your eyes to the blind spots in your relationship.
第二点就是让你看见究竟有什么行为导致你正在杀害着你的婚姻和关系。And
also number 2, to bring to light whatever small behaviors, whether conscious or unconscious, bring to light that is murdering your relationship right now.
那更重要的是到最后，
Most importantly, number 3,
就是要告诉大家我们可以怎么样修补我们的婚姻或关系。
How do we repair, heal our relationships?
那讲了那么多，现在我们快快的进入究竟 我的婚姻现在在怎么阶段？
For this, all is said and done, let me tell you the condition and the state of my marriage.
所以有一些婚姻亮红灯的几个举动，我们来看一看。
So before we go there, there are a lot of signs indicating red lights in a marriage.
那第一个举动留意一下哈。
Now the first one, please.
夫妻们留意一下，如果有这个举动，代表说，哎，婚姻哈，可能亮红灯了。
Husband and wives, you know, please take note of this.
第一就是拒绝身体的靠近。
First one, rejecting physical closeness.
当可能这两夫妻可能有一个开始有距离开始靠近的时候呢，对不对？另外一个会自动移开的。So
this happens when you know one of the pair, either you know the husband or wife, you know, or relationship, they start to you know go for a physical intimacy, and the other refuses it.
他总感觉很抗拒要跟他另一半有近距离的接触。
They absolutely reject the prospect of having any physical intimacy with the other.
很自然的。
Very natural.
你知道吗？我们爱一个人的时候，我们是会有生理反应的。
So you know when we love a person, our body physiologically responds.
对不对？有很多种不同的生理反应，你明白我的意思是不是？ Yeah, 当你爱一个人的时候。
Yes, there's a lot of different biological, physiological response.
你知道，当我们不爱一个人的时候，也会有很多生理反应的，一样。
But I want you to know that when we don't love someone, we will also have physiological and biological reactions.
你知道，爱与不爱，我们的身体是很诚实的。
So whether love or no love, our body is very honest.
所以第一个就是你拒绝身体的靠近。
First, you just reject physical intimacy.
第二个就是拥抱的时候麻木不仁。
Number two, where numbness during embrace.
怎样说呢？当你抱着你的另一半的时候，你感觉到你好像正在抱着石头或抱着木头。
So this happens when you hug your loved one, you feel like you're hugging a rock.
而且对方的麻木呢，对不对？让你很自觉的，你就会松开手了的。
And the numbness from each other is something that you don't feel like continue staying there, and then you just leave.
你会觉得根本没有那个感觉。
You just start saying to yourself like, it doesn't have that feel, that vibe though.
第三，拒绝亲吻。
Number three, refusing a light kiss.
我这里没有讲舌吻啊，是亲吻。
I'm not talking about. You mean deep kissing?
Yeah, French kiss.
I'm not talking about French kiss. I'm talking about light kiss.
Now, Jimmy, 我就知道很厉害这一个。
So I'm told that Jimmy is a professional.
你看 Peggy 笑得多灿烂。
As you can see, how wonderfully.
我们这里没有讲舌吻，我们讲亲吻，因为有些人的确有心理障碍，不喜欢舌吻，觉得很不卫生。
Yeah, because of course, you know, we're not here to talk about French kiss or whatever, because a lot of people might be thinking that it's a kind of unhygienic.
亲吻的意思是蜻蜓点水的，嗯，这样。
Light kiss is just that light tap on the cheek.
那如果有一对丈夫哈、妻子啊，长期性的拒绝亲吻呢、其实是一种表现，他对这个人的嫌弃。
So if you know couples.They refuse light kisses from one another is actually an indicator, a sign that they have a bearing resentment towards each other.
那当然，如果你的另一半拒绝你的亲吻哈，比如说拒绝你的亲吻，因为你当天吃了洋葱的话，那你要理解一下。
Okay. So if the reason that your significant other is refusing a light kiss from you is because you ate a lot of garlic.In this morning's breakfast, then you also need to identify that as a cause as well.
要留意一下，如果长期拒绝亲吻，就是一个嫌弃的表现啊。
So, like refusing a light kiss is actually a sign of resentment.
第四种就是睡觉的时候背靠着背睡。
Okay, so the next one, number four, is sleeping back to back.
就是都不看对方的睡觉的时候。
So it's like not facing each other when you're in your bed.
其实感觉很轻松。
So.You might think that's very casual.
你知道，但是两个人的梦都不一样了。
But let me tell you, the dreams are different.
关系疏离了，也许也降到冰点了。
So this kind of feel, this is kind of a stage in a relationship where it starts to really, you know, go downhill really.
你问一下 Jimmy, you ask 他是不是背对背睡的，两个抱紧紧的
啊？Ask Jimmy whether he sleeps back to back or warm embrace.
这是第四个征兆，第五个，故意挪开眼神。
So number five, deliberately avoiding eye contact.
这两个人不能眼对眼了。
These two people right cannot have eye contact. With
好奇怪的，看到眼睛就要闪了啊。
Very weird. It's like once you almost hit the eye, then
夫妻嘞喂，不能眼对眼，
Imagine,
你不要搞错。
Husband and wife cannot even maintain eye contact.
那相爱的时候，眼睛里只有对方。
Okay, and then.
在相爱的时候，眼睛里只有对方。
Because you know when you're in love, you know your eyes meet, right?
甚至在相爱的时候，眼睛里容不下自己，只有对方。
So in the eyes, you no longer can see just yourself. You can only see the other.
当开始疏离的时候，眼睛里只有自己，
so,
看不到对方了。
But when
几岁啊？这当不相爱了，不爱了。
When you are not in love with each other.The only person we see is ourselves.
所以当这个时候呢，连四目交对，很自然的就会移开眼神，觉得看多一眼都是多余的。
Yeah, so this one right will unconsciously, naturally avoid eye contact.
特别是心里有鬼的哈，更加不敢看眼神。为什么？因为怕泄露了自己里面的一些秘密。
So especially, you know, if you have done something, right? Because you know, something's inside your heart, and when you are afraid that when you get eye contact with each other, you will be discovered out the secret.
因为眼睛会说话的。
Because eyes tell a thousand words.
那第六个就是总是心不在焉。
And then number six, always absent-minded.
怎么讲呢？这两个人总是聊不到一块的，一个聊太阳，一个聊月亮的。
So this one, right? Those two people, they're never on the same page.
所以他没有那种心灵相什么心灵什么契合的那种感受，没有的。
Yeah, so they don't have that synchronization. One talk about the sun, one talk about the moon.
所以基本上对彼此的言语和行动哈、啊、都不感兴趣了，都爱理不理了。
So it's like treating each other's unconscious, you know, gestures, behaviors, all is completely disconnected, knowing nothing about each other.
最后一个特征就是总是撬不开嘴巴。
Always unable to speak up.
怎么讲呢？就是
How do we say this?
有没有试过这种啊？结老婚的啊？有没有试过你问了你的情侣哈、啊，你另一半一个问题，问了半天哦，他说安安静静，忽然间等了很久才啊？有吗？有试过吗
？So let me ask you. You know, have you, you know, in a marriage, you know, after marrying and all that, and you ask your other half a question, you ask them a question, and they stay silent, and maybe perhaps half a day has gone by, you ask them again, and they're like, huh?
其实整个的行为哦，在告诉我们一样事情，就是他拒绝跟你聊天。
So the thing is, all of this concludes that they refuse to communicate.Review.
所以话不投机的，讲多半句都嫌多。
So it's like the more you say, the more worse it becomes.
那今天这里中了多少个
？So I just want to ask you guys, how many of these red lights have you hit?
这个是我们可以去衡量一下我们现在的婚姻状态。
So this can be used as an indicator to as a measuring tool of our marriages.
当然，这一个的情形，它已经现在来到了一个结果了。你看到了这一场的结果。
So, but of course, all of this, right, are actually outcomes that you see.
不过，它是如何发展到这个地步的
？But the question we ask is, how did it come to this?
它不是自然的。
It's not something that's natural.
你知道，冰冻三尺，非一日之寒。
So you know this that ice freezes 3 feet thick.Not in one day's cold.
今天我们来看一看，在圣经里面有一个爱情故事，我要带你们进入的。
So today, let's delve into a love story in the Bible that I want to bring you guys.
就是我们很人见人爱的大卫王故事，爱情故事。
So this is something that we have long awaited, King David's love story.
每次我们讲到大卫王，我们立刻想到的就是八十八。
So the first thing when we think about, when we talk about King David is Bathsheba.
今天我们不讲八十八，我们讲他第一任，他跟第一任老婆的关系。
So we are not going to talk about Bathsheba today, but we're going to talk about his first wife.
他的第一个老婆叫米甲。
Michal, 哎。
对。
Oh, then we're going to talk about his first wife, which is Michal.
那米甲是谁呢？米甲就是扫罗王的女儿。
So who is Michal? Michal is the daughter of King Saul, the first king of Israel.
我们要看一看大卫跟米甲之间一开始很炽热的爱情怎么降到冰点。
So we will right now look into this on how their passionate love at the beginning turned to ice cold Antarctica.
所以我们来读一读这个经，我们一起来啊，中文的一二三。大卫和跟随他的人起身前往，杀了200非利士人，将羊皮满束交给王，为要做王的女婿。于是扫罗将女儿米甲给大卫为妻。扫罗见耶和华与大卫同在，又知道女儿米甲爱大卫，就更怕大卫，常做大卫的仇敌。
So it says here that David took his men with him, went out and killed 200 Philistines and brought back their foreskins. They counted out the number to the king so that David might become the king's son-in-law. Then Saul gave him his daughter Michal in marriage. When Saul realized that the Lord was with David and that his daughter Michal loved David, Saul became still more afraid of him and remained his enemy the rest of his days.
你知道对扫罗王来讲，他是害怕大卫，妒忌大卫。他其实有一个策略。
So it's actually very afraid of David, fearful.
就是他要把他的女儿嫁给大卫。
So that So he has actually had a scheme. He gave his daughter Michal to David in marriage.
不是真正纯心想要让他女儿嫁给他。
But of course it's not really, you know, like, oh, Michal.
他就跟大卫讲，如果你想要娶我的女儿，可以去杀100个非利士人，把他们的羊皮，羊皮就是那个包皮的意思，明白吗？ 你明白还是不明白？ 就不是吃包的包皮。 就是男生的性器官的那个皮，明白吗 ？OK， 所以他要他杀100个非利士人，之后把他们的包皮割下来之后献给王。So
King Saul said that, oh, it's not easy. If you want to marry my daughter, what you're gonna do is you gotta go to 200 Philistines, kill them, bring their foreskins. You know, if you guys know what foreskin means, you don't know, you just Google it. I'm not gonna explain it, but foreskins, bring it back to me. Then only I let Michal marry.
那这个策略是什么？就是想要大卫王死在非利士人的手里。
So King Saul's intention is to let David die in the hands of this Philistine.
换句话说，这一个的行动任务是非常极具危险的。
So this decree is actually a decree that's very dangerous.
所以扫罗王就是想要大卫死，所以一定要把他暴露在最危险的情况底下。
So Saul wants David to die, so he's going to put him in the most dangerous situation.
不过，即便那么样的危险，
but even though how dangerous it is,
因为大卫爱米迦，
because David loved Michal,
所以他愿意去冒这个险。
So he was willing to take the risk.
他就去杀，不止杀100个，杀够200个给他。
Actually, he didn't just kill 100, but he killed an additional 100.
所以从这里我们可以看到，哇，这炽热的爱情哦，彼此是不是愿意冒险为了娶到美人归，是吗？
So this one is like, wow, the willingness to, you know, go through that danger in order to get another.
那很快的，扫罗王用这个方法杀不到大卫之后，当他嫁给了米迦，嫁给了大卫之后呢，扫罗王还是想办法想要去到他的家暗杀大卫。
So right, that this thing is not enough for King Saul. King Saul grew fearful of David and sent assassins to assassinate David in his home.
那当然米甲是他的女儿，所以米甲应该要跟他合作，他也让米甲知道这个事情。
So of course Michal is the daughter of King Saul. So King Saul scheme wanted to put her, include her in the scheme to cooperate with the father.
不过米甲做了什么呢？我们读一下这个经文，他说：“于是米甲将大卫从窗户里坠下去，大卫就逃走躲避了。米甲把家中的神像放在床上，头枕在山羊毛装的枕头上，用被盖着。扫罗打发人去做大卫，米甲说他病了。扫罗又打发人去见大卫，说连当连床将他抬来，我好杀他。使者进去看见床上有神像。” 头枕在山羊毛装的枕头上，扫罗对米甲说：“你为什么这样欺哄我，放我的仇敌逃走呢？”我觉得不用读了哈，你大概说哈，跟着我。那他的意思是在这里，我们清楚的看到米甲没有帮他的爸爸，他是帮大卫，因为他爱大卫，他冒着生命的危险。你要知道，如果你不听王的话，米甲可能也会死，因为他多的是女人，他多的是女儿。 而且女儿在那一个时候的什么呢的光景，不是不比儿子高的地位 ，All right?
So as you can see here, Michal braved the risk of disobeying her father, the king. And during last time in the olden days, disobeying a king would be considered as treason. And somehow she is the daughter, one of the many daughters. Saul actually had many, many daughters. All right? And, you know, she braved this risk. And some of the status of women in the past is very, very low. So she braved the risk for someone she loves.
所以你可以看到这两个年轻人炽热的爱情，他们可以为彼此摆上生命的代价。
So as you can see, the love of these two young people, they're willing to lay their lives down.
所以我问大家，他们爱彼此吗？
So let me ask you guys, do they love each other?
爱不爱？
Love or not?
Okay, 现在看看你老公和老婆，你问我，你爱我吗？
Look at your husband or your wife or your partner. Ask them, do you love me?
当然爱了，不爱的哪里会走在一起
？Of course, love. You know how we're going to go through this together.
付了多少代价，应该是幸福美满的结局，对还是不对
？How much cost that we need to bear in order to, you know, have this happy life?
不过很悲哀的，我们看一下他们的结局吧。
So, but then,
结婚很多年以后，来到这一个事件，我们看到耶和华的约柜进了大卫城的时候，扫罗的女儿米甲从窗户里看见，在大见大卫王在耶和华面前踊跃跳舞，心里就轻视他。 大卫回家要给眷属祝福，扫罗的女儿米甲出来迎接他说，以色列王今日在城仆的婢女面前露体，如同一个轻贱人无耻露体一样，有好大的荣耀啊。
Tragedy happened years later as we see this situation here.
啊，就是你看到当大卫王在神面前跳舞的时候，突然间这一个的米甲看到了之后，他是轻视他，甚至出来讽刺他。Wow.
So, whereas David was dancing, worshiping God in a prayer in the midst of people, his wife Michal came up and to criticize him in this way.
In which way?
with these words, right?
Okay, 你要不要讲一下？
什么？要讲什么？这
个？没事，这样我们继续。
Okay, 继续。
Okay. 所以从这里，为什么一个那么炽热的爱情到最后来到这个地步？他已经轻看大卫，甚至讽刺他，出言在人面前讽刺大卫，没有给大卫面子哦。
So this one, right? This thing happens is that she didn't give David any face or save his reputation. She just outright in front of everyone say this to him.
故事到这里之后，米迦之后就再也没有出现在圣经的另一些故事里面。
So after this incident, she did not appear in any other books or chapters.In the Chronicles.
这是最后一句讲到米迦的故事，就是扫罗的女儿米迦，直到死的那日没有生养儿女。
And the final part that mentions Michal in the Bible says that Michal, daughter of Saul, had no children to the day of her death.
意思是要告诉我们什么？为什么她会没有生养儿女？为什么
？So this tells us something. Why did she have bear no children?
为什么？猜一下。
Why? Guess.
为什么她会没有生养儿女，直到死那一天？
So until the day of her death.
猜一下为什么他没有？没有关系哈。P two 很清楚。
P two 是有关系。
就是换句话说，大卫王没有去跟他行房啊。
So it means it's very straightforward. David never took her to bed.
大卫王看到他都嫌弃了啊，不爽了，怎么跟他行房呢
？When David just one look at her.He also have a lot of resentment in his heart. How are they going to do anything else?
换句话说，到最后，他们这一个关系里面已经没有他们的婚姻关系里面已经没有性关系了。
So in their relationship, there's no freshness to it at all.
Means 他没有 sexual relationship.
No sexual relationship at all.
So 为什么他换句话说他是孤独到老的
？So you can say that she was lonely up till death.
一个那么炙热的爱情，一开始的时候的结局是这样的。到底什么事情发生了
？A very strong and passionate love at the beginning ended up like this. What happened in the middle?
圣经没有告诉我们。
The Bible does not tell us.
不，我相信一般我们可以看见的婚姻关系破裂的时候，都离不开它的原因都相当相似的。
So the thing is, we cannot avoid because every relationship, every marriage all have a similar.Cause of the ending, we can't avoid it.
我们知道一个婚姻的问题，到甚至婚姻的结局到结束哈，比如说被破坏之后，有很多不一样的因素。Factor.
So there's actually, as we look at all this, there are plenty of factors that bring about an end to a relationship.
今天我只要专注在三个行为，你是否有在谋杀着你的婚姻
？So today I want to focus on three behaviors that we may be intentionally doing to murder the relationship.
记得，婚姻不会自然死亡的，关系不会自然死亡的，都是我们采取的一些行动去把它杀了。
So let me tell you that naturally, there's no such thing as natural ending or you know.To a marriage or relationship, it is things that we continuously choose, the choices that we choose to do, that end up murdering.
第一个行为就是受害者的心态。我们常常都在埋怨着彼此，指责彼此。
So the first one is having the victim mentality, victim mindset that we start to put the blame and accuse one another.
当我们去回想一下，在我们的婚姻生活当中，是否这一样的情形常常出现？我们心里面常常觉得说，都是因为你我才这样。
So how many times, right, that in a relationship or people that we know that we have this, like, or all the trouble that I have right now or something like that is because of you.
因为你没有做好，所以导致到我现在生气。
Because of you, you didn't do well. That's why I'm angry now.
因为你没有赚足够的钱，导致我忧虑。
Because you didn't earn enough money, that's why I'm worrying myself to death now.
因为你都没有从来没有理我的感受的，导致了我现在觉得很寂寞。
Because you never acknowledge and care about my feelings, so that's why I feel very lonely now.
有没有很熟悉？
Is this very sound? Does it sound familiar to you?
而我想告诉大家的是，其实基本上我们人性哈都非常的很普遍，我们常常都有受害者的心态，这是很自然的，在我们的生命里面。
So let me tell you, this is a very typical condition of the human heart. We always have the victim mentality to blame someone other than ourselves.
我想告诉大家的是，如果你不是受害者心态的话，你是正面积极的话，那是反常态的。反自然的。
Oh, so if you are not blaming anybody or your other half, you are someone that is.
没有，还没有讲，这个是反常态的。如果你不是受害者，你常常很积极的去应对问题的那种人，你是很反常态的。反常态的意思就不是你是不正常的。
Oh, OK，
它不是自然发生的。
Okay. If you are someone that doesn't have the victim mentality, right? You don't have the victim mindset. You just face problems right there and on. You are extraordinary.
对。所以换句话说，当我们要去积极面对问题的时候，它是一个选择来的。
So because all of it, right? Having to solve problems together.Going through this, facing it together is a choice.
你必须很刻意的，所谓的很刻意的要去做这个行为。
You need to be 100% intentional in behaving this to solve the problem.
受害者心态是我们很自然就会有的。
Victim mindset, blaming others is something that is inherently natural to us.
所以为什么 Facebook 上面或者 social media 上面，常常看到很多人在埋怨？很多人在 complain， 因为很多人都是活在受害者的心态里面。
So as you can see in social media, people always use social media to take to their complain and vent out their bitterness because victim mindset.
不过我们完全的相信，觉得每一件的事情都是别人加害在我们身上。
Because we believe that every problem that we have right now is due to other people.
当我们完全相信的时候，我告诉你，它是一个很严重的问题。
Because when we really fully believe in this, having this victim mindset, it actually poses a huge problem.
因为我们永远不会做任何的改变，因为是别人的问题。
Because we will never ever make changes to ourselves because it's always their fault.
听清楚，当我们有受害者心态的时候，我们永远不会改变。
Listen carefully. When we all have the victim mindset, we will never change.
为什么？因为错不在我，我改什么
？Because think about it.If I'm not in the wrong, why would I have to change?
他要改嘛
He will need to change.
我在等他改啊
I'm just waiting for her or him to change.
你知道我多痛苦吗？等到
You know how painful it is to wait.
是他不改
It's because of them that don't change.
我不用改
I don't have to change.
我没有东西需要改
I have nothing at all to change.
是他的问题
It's their problem.
第二个
Number two,
谋杀的行为就是把自己的感受憋在心里不说。
So third thing that burdens a marriage is keeping one's feelings bottled up.
有多少时候你常常都没有真正的跟你的另一半好好沟通你的感受是什么
？How many times have we avoided, you know, just going to our partner, sitting down and just to communicate to each other how we feel?
有多少时候是你都是心里在自己跟自己说，你看他又来了。
How many times we always tell ourselves, see, there he or she goes again, there they go again.
你看讲这么多次，他就是不会听的。
See, I told already so many times, still don't listen.
闲聊啊
I'm really bored of this.
我都不知道干嘛我会娶到这样的女人。
I'm so tired of this. I don't even know how I get this. How I get together with this.
你里面有很多的气，很多的自我对话。
You have a lot of inner dialogue.
不，从来你没有跟他表达过你自己心里面真正的感受。
But you have never expressed to them how you truly felt.
尤其是女人
，especially females.
你觉得你们应我的另一半应该要懂的。
For women saying that, oh, our husbands,
跟你在一起那么多年，你还不懂我啊
？Should naturally know. Stay together with me so many years, really, how you still don't know?
所以很多时候我们就觉得认为对方应该要懂。
So how many times we keep on saying that?Our other half need to know absolutely without me telling them.
所以我不说。
So I don't say.
所以我就觉得说，你看他故意的。
You see, this is see. Look at them purposely one.
明明知道我不喜欢这个，他就偏偏去做。
Obviously to know that I don't like this, but I still do it.
第三个谋杀婚姻的行为，就是把对方的感受排在心外，不听。
Putting the other person's feelings aside, not listening.
刚才第二个讲到，不说放在心里面，之后人家他跟你讲他的感受的时候，你就把他排在心外，不要听。
So the second one is you don't talk, but the third one is when people communicate and talk to us, we put it aside.
这三大行为，如果你一直在做，我告诉你，你是蓄意的，正在谋杀着你的婚姻。
So these three behaviors, if you continuously do it, these are the three things that are murdering your relationship.
有多少时候我们一直觉得我们的另一半可能一直在跟你讲，不过你一直觉得他很烦的？有多少人是有这种感受的？放下手。
So how many times? Okay. How many times that when your other half communicates to you and you find it is very annoying and you're fed up?Put down your hands.
一直讲，讲了多少次先呐、啊、
？How many times say, continue talk.
我不是已经回应过，我不是已经解释给你听了没？为什么你还要讲
？I thought I've already communicated and responded to you. This why do you keep talking about this again and again?
你知道什么？他一直讲吗
？You know why they keep on talking?
因为你没有真正的听。
Because you're not really listening.
如果你真正的有解决到他的问题，他不会再讲了。
If you really solve the problem.They won't have a reason to continue talking about it.
如果你真正理解他的感受，他没有理由还会在那边发猛掌啊！你明白我的意思吗？在那边闹情绪，不会的。
If you really understood, make them feel that their feelings are hurt and understood, they wouldn't continue being in this state.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹
，Brothers and sisters,
今天这三大行为
，Today these three behaviors,
如果都在你的身上，记得我要你那就像你身边的那个人跟他说，今天这场道我是为我自己听的，不是为你听的。
I want you to nudge the person next to you and tell them that this sermon I listen it for my, not for anyone else, for myself.
很多时候会讲你啊，哪看 Pastor Vincent 讲了他呢，听一下啦，你听一下。
Because most of you will be like this, nudging and say, hey, see, Pastor Vincent.
你希望借着我的口来杀掉你的。
listen,
so 借刀杀人。
You are planning to use my words right to murder your partner's relationship.
这场道是为自己听的。
This one is for you yourself.
我们一起讲，这场道是为我自己听的。
Say to yourself, this is for me.
Amen. 大家醒来了。Amen.
Okay,
Hallelujah.
Everybody's waking up.
好，我要讲一讲这，对，你知道吗？这句话很有意思。他说，一个爱自己理想中爱情过于现实中爱情的人，往往就是自己爱情的破坏者。
So it says here very, very, insightful. It says a person who loves the ideal of love they have for themselves too much often becomes the destroyer of the love they have in reality.
明白他的意思吗
？Do you understand what it's trying to
say? 你知道我们为什么现在的婚姻越来越破裂吗
？Do you know why
很脆弱吗
？Do you know why our relationships are becoming very brittle and fragile in this age?
让我们受害者一下，我们要怪那个 Korean 的 drama。
So, let's right now adopt the victim mentality and blame the Korean dramas.
因为他们把那个图片画得太过美好了。
Because they have painted such a rose-colored lens picture.
导致很多的少男少女们呢，对这一个的爱情充满着憧憬。
So, that it has led astray the young men and women of this age.
当我讲少男少女的时候，也包括了40岁以上的那些。
Young men, young women, I also mean 40-year-old people also.
他们因为他们还在看 Korean drama.
Because they still watch Korean drama.
平时婚姻太枯干了，要去看一下。
So sometimes the marriage gets a bit dry, so they watch together lah.
你知道我们的这个婚姻，我们对我们自己的婚姻有一个理想画面，很幸福的。
So this imagery that we have of marriage and relationship is something that's so rainbows and sunshine.
这个没有错。
Well, this is not wrong.
不过我们要醒。
But we need to wake up.
因为我们活在一个现实的世界，不会有那么完美的理想的婚姻的。
Because we live in a fallen world, there is no such thing as something that is perfectly smooth sailing.
所以当一个人他一直憧憬着他那个理想的婚姻的那个图片的时候，当他又在看到他现实的那个老公的死人样的时候。
So if they use the very beautiful picture painted by the media as a reference for their love, and they look at their husband's very dead face.
你说痛不痛苦？
Very, you know, that kind of black, not being
colorful
here, but they're very
痛苦啊
resentful face. Do you see it very, very hard?
很痛苦啊，听你发音。
Painful, sorry. I'm trying to I'm trying to translate this in a way that understands. Sorry.
差不多我看到人家那个叫什么名我都不知道叫什么名那种哇很浪漫的时候看到他现在的那个睡样那老公的睡样痛苦吗 Peggy 痛苦吗 不痛苦啦你老公很帅
So after seeing all of that and then seeing your partner, wow, such a disparity.
你知道当这样看的时候一直这样比较的时候你心里面怎么能够平衡
So after you seeing that, comparing your the guy and the relationship right now, how do you reconcile this difference in the relationship?
我想告诉你，你那一个理想的完美婚姻是永远不会在现实生活里面发生的。
So this kind of thing that you see in those media and those beautiful picture painted will not be something that you see in your relationship.
所以当你一直憧憬这个，你一直 complain 这个，你看到你这个现实的时候，你就一直不满，你一直不满的时候，你就一直埋怨，一直埋怨，气往心里面憋，一直憋。他讲什么，你觉得这条烦呐、啊，这个人烦，你不听到最后，整个婚姻就是被你搞垮的。
So in all those things that you see the difference in relationship, if you don't reconcile it, you keep on seeing it so different from the picture that you envision, and you start to complain, and you start to criticize, you start to critique, you start to badmouth.
你知道吗？我看了一套这个在 MCU 的时候，我曾经说过，看了一套这个叫做 AI 的 Humans， 他讲到以后的这个世界里面，他们能够做出一个 robot 这些好像人一样真的，他们。 人一样真哦，他能够走到像一个人家一模一样这样的样子，他能，你能够买他回来服侍你的，成为你的 mate。
Okay, so I haven't told you guys this, but during the midst of the pandemic, I've been watching this show. Actually, it's about an AI show that is about humans 2.0. This one where that you can actually purchase AI to be your friend, to serve you, to do a lot of different household things at all.
你知道在那个里面的有一个情节，我觉得非常好的，就是你知道当他们开始请的这些所谓的人工智能的，怎么讲啊，佣人在家的时候，婚姻开始发生变化了。Okay,
so it's very interesting as I see right that when they purchase this AI to bring to their household, their marriage starts to change.
你想一下，这些 AI 人又漂亮，脾气又好。
As you can see, right, these AIs are so good looking,
and then
they have great body figures, and their temper, they don't really have tempers.
而且哦，你跟他讲什么都好，他永远是 Yes, madam.
So and then whatever you say to them, they'll be like Yes, madam.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
他，你叫他做什么，他永远不会 say no 的.
So whatever you ask them to do, they will never say no.
他永远，他的活着就为了你。
So the purpose of their existence is for you.
所以婚姻能不变吗?
So do the marriage? Don't you think it wouldn't change?
所以我就觉得那导演厉害，编剧厉害，他把这一部分婚姻的这部分凸显了出来。
So I think the director is really great in this because he's managed to bring this aspect of a relationship out.
所以导致有很多的婚姻开始破裂，因为他们觉得说他们的老公，他们看到他们老公，他都显了，他觉得哇，你看我这个哇。 Ben 呢？他可以讲笑话给我听，他可以哄我，他可以抱着我，他可以，然后他永远服侍我，都不会 complain， 不会累的。哇，不要这样的男人。
Yes, sir. Okay, the thing is, because the director actually shows this out, because you see, right? Oh, I've been having relationship problems with my other half, my spouse. But then when I go to this perfect AI, you know, with good. Perfect body shape, never says no to me, always wants to serve me, always listens and understands me. How can the marriage not change?
所以换句话说，他这里告诉了我们一个信息：原来我们进入婚姻哦，其实我们在寻找的真正的不是一个伴侣，我们在寻找一个全职的菲佣。
So actually, right, when we want to get into relationship, what we are really looking for is not a human partner. But actually, a slave.
不要笑我
Don't laugh.
在讲你啊，笑什么
？Talking about you, laugh. Talking about you, what you laughing about?
我也在讲我自己 ，OK.
I'm also saying myself, OK.
这个是来就想讲一下这一个这对情侣的关系。
So I also at the same time want to talk about this.
每次看 Jimmy 讲，我是时候我讲一下哇。
Every time I hear Jimmy talk about his relationship，
每次在那边撒狗粮
I also need to talk about my one 啊。 Every time hear Jimmy talk about his love story， I'm bored already。 Yeah， listen to mine。
你知道我的厉害咯。
You know, I want, you know, my one, very, very, very great, you know.
我和我的老婆初恋呢。初恋是 first love 啦。
Me and my wife, actually, we are each other's first love.
哇，很浪漫，对不对？哇，
very,
很理想，对不对
？Very romantic, right？
哇，
very,
看到了就觉得说超浪漫的嘞。
哇 ，Every time we look at this, like, 哇 ，so romantic。
还可以生五个那么多，一定很爱 can, 很爱彼此哦。
Can get out five children, they must have loved each other so much。
还不爱谁爱啊？啊，对不对？那我想跟大家分享的不是什么，是我们很痛苦的那一面。
I would like to share the story of actually the very ugly.Can I say
ugly side,
the ugly side or the painful side of our relationship.
看到那么笑得那么甜，我告诉你，在2014年，我们两个的感情就掉入了冰点。2014年。
Okay, so as you can see, these very sweet diabetic smiles, right? But then, right, actually, in 2014, our relationship get a real big problem.
那时候那一年是我的第二个女儿出世。
So on that year, my second 第二个女儿 my second daughter was born.
而且也是同一年 Live Tree Cafe 开的时候。
And it's also the same year that Live Tree Cafe opened for the first time.
所以在那个时候其实基本上我是非常非常的忙碌。
So during that time, my schedule was absolutely packed.
你想一下，要管理 教会的事工，同一个时候要管理这个的 Live Tree Cafe 的这个 business, 哇、wow, 我真的是还有家庭把我拉得真的是怎么说四面啊、粉碎啊啊
！So I had the ministry to take care of. I had the business to take care of. I had my family to take care of. Yes, really stretched me to the maximum.
那一年其实我也得了轻微的忧郁症，轻微的啊、mild depression.
So during that time, I also kind of suffered from some sort of mild depression.
因为太大压力了，因为很多人好像对你很多的期待，要满足很多人的期待。
Because I felt that the pressure was so great that everybody had expectations.
我一上到 Live Tree 在那一年，我看到人我都讨厌。
So the minute right that year, whenever I go up Live Tree Cafe, whenever I see people, I'm like, oh.
我看到那么可爱的大学生们，我都觉得讨厌。那时候
I see them very cute university campus students, so I'm like,
oh. 因为我觉得这帮人只会拿，不会给，不会感恩的。
So
those, 只会 complain.
Because I said to myself, wow, those campus students, right, all they know how to do is take, receive, don't know how to give one, don't know how to contribute one, only complain.
所以那么多的这个压力底下，到每当我回到家的时候，我希望家能够成为我的温暖。
So because of all this external pressure, you know, I hope that when I go home, I will receive the warmth of a home.
我一回到家的时候，我就看到了一颗炭。
炭。
Chaco.
So right.
You want me to translate?
Yeah.
Okay. So whenever I when I go home, all I see is a charcoal.
Charcoal. 我不是讲我老婆黑，我的意思是，我的意思 charcoal 是他的脸啊，黑黑看着我。
Disclaimer 啊 ，it's not talking about skin color 啊。Okay. Whenever I reach back home, when I look at my wife, I'm not talking about the color darkness of her face. I'm talking about metaphorically.Her face was very dark. Looking at me,
我看到她的样子啊，我已经超不爽。
Whenever I look at her face, right, I started getting so uncomfortable and resentful.
因为她看我也不爽。
Because she also looked at me in the same way.
为什么呢？因为那段时间她有三个孩子要应付，她在家里面有很多的压力和苦水，她觉得需要我更多的在她身边，她觉得没有时间，我没有时间给她。
Because during that time, she was alone in the house taking care of three children, you know, taking care of the house chores, cooking, the work, job, and also all of things, and she needed my support.
每次我回到家的时候，她看到我，她也嫌。
So every time when I come home and she look at me, she's fed up.
我的妻子是那种把东西放在心里憋着不说的。
My wife is a type where she when have something happens she keeps it inside her heart she doesn't say it out.
她只放在脸上。
She just put it on her face. She doesn't write it on her heart. She writes it on her face.
所以我回到家，我看到她的脸，我已经超不爽，我忍。
So every time when I come back to the house and I see her face like this, I also was very, very, I don't feel good about it, and I just tolerated her.
So 我对她也很多期待，我就看到家这个做不好，那个做不好，心想你在家干嘛？
So when I had also expectations for her. So when I see some things in the house that is not quite right, and I said, what on earth are you doing in this house?
我回来，我希望是有一个舒适温暖的家。
Because every time I come back, I hope that I have a very warm and comfortable home.
我回到来不是我可以做的话，我帮你做；做不到的话，你也应该要理解。
So when I come home, I expect that if I can help you, if I have energy to help you, I'll help you. But if I can't help you, I don't have the energy to do it. You also need to understand that.
有时候教会突然间晚上需要开会，有一些人需要我去 counseling，我跟他讲，我都怕，懂吗？
So sometimes, When I tell her that, you know, sometimes, you know, the church has an emergency meeting. Sometimes I got to have counseling with someone or meet up, someone or follow up, you know. And every time I tell this, I'm actually get quite scared, you know.
我很怕跟她讲之后看她的，她又给我那个黑脸看。
I'm really scared to tell her because right, every time when I tell her that time, she give me this kind of face.
所以我就什么，为了壮胆呢，我就先凶咯。
So in order to, you know, to pretend and act strong and like I be the one that act fierce first.
好像一副不在乎的那种，我等到几点，我有 counseling 啊，我就说。
So to mask my fear, I will be the one that being fierce and aggro first. I will just say that, hey, you know, later 2:30, 3:30, I have counseling, then I just leave.
所以整个过程其实在那一些年日，在2014年，我们两个其实都对彼此很失望。
So in the entire process of that year, our disappointment for each other grew.
因为一直觉得对方没有去用我们要爱的语言去爱彼此，没有。
Because we see each other not willing to use our love languages to love each other.
所以我们完全都没什么说话了。
So we completely cut off conversations and talking.
那之后。 有很多的苦毒，很多的苦水在里面，双方。
A lot of bitterness and resentment broiling between.
之后我记得有一次我们吵架吵到很顶点的时候。
I remember one time we had a really big fight.
我很记得，那看给你看一下我丑陋的一面。
Let me see you. Let me let you see the ugly side of me.
我记得那一天我气到一个程度，我。 没有动手，不要这个样，我不会动手的 ，OK， 全部在期待着我动手的。So
during that time, I was so angry, and don't look at me like this. I did not do any physical abuse. Stop looking at me like that.
我指着他。
I pointed at her.
她那时候在流泪。
During that time, tears were flowing from her eyes.
我说你不要在我面前流泪。
I say, don't you dare have any tears on your face in front of me.
你流的泪不会让我去疼惜你。
Your tears won't buy any sympathy or pity from me.
只会让我厌烦.
You only make me feel annoyed.
你知道为什么我会这样说吗？
You know why I say that?
因为我常常心里面有一种想法，是你用眼泪在钉我的罪。
Because I always have this thinking that you are using tears to condemn me of my sin.
你用眼泪来告诉我说我做错了很多。 是我把你伤害的。
So you're using your tears to say that I did a lot of wrong and that I am responsible for you like this.
你用眼泪把我钉在十字架上。
You use your tears to crucify me on the cross, responsible for your hurt.
我那时候不是这样讲的，我是心里这样想。
But of course, I didn't say during like that during the time. This was in my heart.
所以为什么我很无情冷漠的指着来这样骂？但是我唯一一次这样骂他。
So during the time, I apathetically and the only time in my life that I scolded her this way.
当我骂了她之后，我就转身离开去书房。
So when after I voiced out and mouthed out at her, I just straight went to my room and
坐在我的椅子上，我就开始埋怨，跟神埋怨。
I sat on my chair and I started complaining immediately to God.
我跟神说，神够了。
God's like God, I've had enough.
我受够这个女人了。
I had enough of this woman.
我讲。 难道他不知道我现在不是在玩乐吗？在外面，我在做工作，我在服侍，我现在有了一个 cafe， 我还要 manage， 我已经很多压力了。他也只是在家里照顾一下孩子，你不能够体谅我吗？
I complain to God, doesn't this woman know that I'm not going out there, outside there, having fun, you know, having the time of my life? I'm out there serving. I'm out there battling, fighting, warrior for ministry, cafe, people's expectations, a pastor's job and all that. And I'm coming back home. And what is she doing? She's only staying in the house, taking care of the children, doing house chores. Right? How come she can't understand me?
So, 你在我慢慢慢慢慢慢之后，我安静了下来。
After all my complaining, I silent myself.
就神突然间有一句话，我觉得来得很奇怪。那一句话，神一跟我讲的时候，我整个人很诧异。So
during that time, suddenly when I quietened myself down, suddenly God responded in a way that is so unexpected.
突然间一个的经文出现在我脑海，在当下我那么生气的时候，他突然出现在我脑海一个经文，我很清楚是神。
So during that time, in my anger, right, and my heavy breathing, like suddenly a verse that I remembered suddenly popped into my mind, and I knew it was from God.
他说，背起你的十字，若有人要跟从我，背起你的十字架来跟随我。
The verse was like, anyone who would follow me, bear your cross daily and come with me.
我觉得这个不是用在施工的，妹妹。
I say,
干嘛你在我在婚姻出现问题，你跟我讲这番话？
I say, God, like, isn't this first used for the context of ministry and missionaries, why use it in my marriage?
因为那么多年，我常常做牧师那么多年，常用这个经文，就是叫人去服侍了。喂。<laughs> Because
of my many years as pastor, I always use this verse to spur the people to serve.
所以我觉得这个经文来的肯定不是我自己想的。I
say because that's how I know that this verse suddenly come right. It's not from me.
神讲你。 不是说要跟随我吗？你不是很会讲这个经文的吗？这个时候你就要用这个经文了。So
God said to me, haven't you used this verse constantly a lot of times on people? Now I want you to apply this to yourself. Didn't you say you're going to follow me? Apply this verse to yourself.
原来神这个经文在这个时候用的非常恰当，就是你要把你自己的需要情绪钉在十字架上，舍掉，背起十字架，去爱你的老婆。It
was such a timely reminder, you know, to put asking me to deny myself, putting all my needs at the moment right aside, nail it on the cross, serve and love my wife.
原来这样叫做背十字架，这样叫做舍己，懂吗？
So this is the meaning of bearing my cross, of denying myself.
舍掉你很多的理想，对爱情的理想，回到神原本对婚姻的设置和对婚姻的设计和心意。
To nail to the cross and put aside all your various imageries of what's supposed to look like and come back to how God originally defined it as.
神从来没有要给我们一个完美的婚姻。
God has never intended to give us a perfect marriage.
神却给了这个一个婚姻，这个婚姻是一个最完美的平台，来塑造我们每一个人。
God used marriage as a very, very perfect instrumental platform to call us.
学习怎么样去爱。
To learn how to love.
我知道时间已经不多了，现在很快的想要进入。今天我只要说一点，究竟我们可以学习现在开始怎么修补你的这个感情、你这个婚姻，做一样事情，今天就够了。
Without wasting time, I want to go through the steps on how to repair or heal your marriage. If it's just one step, let me tell you what it is.
而我告诉你，而这一步。 是往往所有人都不做的。So
this step right, actually a majority of people do not do.
所以现在跟我拍拍你身边人，跟他说你都不做的，听清楚，来跟他讲，你平时不做的。
Pat to the person next to you and tell them that this is something you don't do one.
那爱的行为是什么？做一个就够了，万事通，万事灵。你无论现在你的婚姻面对什么问题啊，你只要做这一个，万事通，万事灵。相信我。
So the behavior of love, right? You don't have to say anything much. What thousands of steps to do? It's just this one thing, very one thing. All you have to do is just this one thing.
不是亲吻，听清楚，试看，就是这个。一起说，一二三，没有错。
Active listening.
而且不仅仅要讲聆听，应该讲积极聆听。
So it is not to just ask you to listen, but it's asking you to seek first.
所以拿着这一句话来去反复思考，成为你的钥匙，补救你关系的钥匙，就是先求了解，再争取被理解。So
put this into your heart and really use it as a key to date your relationships. Seek first to understand and then to be understood.
这一招如果你能不断地去做的话，我告诉你，你无论在什么关系，你都会痛的。
So let me tell you, if you are able to consistently and continuously do it in your relationships, you
通，不是痛。
You'll be able to walk it through. Sorry, thought it's pain. Walk it through.
所以很多时候我们都要人家听我的，了解我先，把这个先放下，把自己先放下。 要做的事情就是什么呢？先去了解那一个人，因为当那个人被理解，他感受到被理解之后，你才去争取让他理解你。如果能够做到这一点，很多东西通了。
Normally we have the mindset that you know, we want people to listen to us. Why aren't they listening? Why can't they understand us? But instead, we don't put it aside. Instead, right, we put it all aside for a while at the moment first to really seek to understand them. To listen to them before then sharing our needs and our feelings.
讲真，我们从来不喜欢聆听别人。
Let me tell you, inherently, we never like listening to other people.
所以我们真的要学习这个很重要的功课。
That's why we have to remember this very important lesson.
只要你这一招做得好，我跟你讲，任何关系你都通了。If
you are able to do this one thing well, it will all actually managed to work out.
你知道李小龙曾经讲过一句话。
You know, Bruce Lee did say a quote.
不是比来我的，不是这句常常用烂了。
It's not be like water. This one is overused.
不是讲过我不怕一个人学一万招功夫的，一万招啊，我不怕他去学一万招。
I'm not. He says that I'm not afraid of the man that have learned 1,000 moves.
我只害怕一个人，他学一招，他练一万次。
And I am more afraid of the man who practices the same move millions of times.
今天我不需要给你很多很多的方法怎么去修补，你做好这一招，你去 practice 一万次，先听，不要争着说，而且听的时候要甘愿的听。
I'm telling you right now, I'm not going to give you a lot of different methodologies and ways to, you know, behavior of love. But I'm just giving you this one, and I want you to practice this a million times, you know, and you just practice to listen to your partner, not unwillingly or reluctantly, but really, you know, to listen.
可能你会问怎么做聆听怎么做？那我现在告诉你三点，很快的哈，只要你很清楚的怎样去 practice 这个东西。
Maybe ask me why? How to do it? Right? Okay, let me tell you in these three easy levels.
Okay, 要不要知道
？Want to know?
要啊。Now,
okay, let's go.
Level one 最基本的，先 practice level one.
Okay, let's practice level one.
一起说，能重复对方的原话。
First one, I can repeat the other person's words.
很多人呢，你跟他讲的，他的样子很认真哦。
A lot of people, right?
我们都是天生的演员。
So, a lot of times, right, you tell people, right, they look at you very earnestly and nodding their head. Talented actors.
当然很少人会问，哎，我刚才说什么？ 很少人会去问我刚才说什么。
A lot of course, a lot of people very less will say that. So, what did I say just now?
我现在想要告诉你，你要 practice 哦，你自己问自己刚刚他说了什么。
So I want you to practice by yourself. You ask yourself just now what he or she said.
就是因为为什么你妈妈常常唠叨你，为什么你老婆常唠叨你，因为她所说你根本没有听。
So why is your woman, your spouse keep on or your mother constantly nagging to you? It's because that whatever they say you don't listen.
当他讲的东西你能重复多少句？我问你。
What they say to you just now, how many words can you repeat out?
这个是最基本立刻能够做的操练，真正的专注的给他 attention， 他所讲的东西好好的能够重复出来吗？
This ultimately is the most basic one. So, whatever he or she said, can you repeat it out word for word?
所以这是第一招哦。So
this first one.
Now level two.
Level two.
当你能够完整的听到他所讲的，接着下来你就是能够明白他的意思是什么，抓到他要表达的意思。
The second one, right, is I can understand the other person's meaning. What are they really trying to say?
不要紧紧的，怎么说？ 你用你自己的意思盖在上面，很多时候是哎，你不用讲，我知道你要讲什么了。
So because sometimes oftenly, right, we use our own ideologies and view, right, to interpret what they're trying to say. I already know what you're trying to say, lah.
Now, 第三个才是最重要的。
This is the most important one, number three, most important.
你前面两个做到，没有做到第三个，前面两个都是废的。
So if you don't do number three, right, level one and level two is completely useless.
如果你能够 做到第三，哎，你如果前面两个没有做，你做到第三个啊，你也很成功了。
Even though you don't do level 1 and 2, even though you don't do level 1 and 2 and you still do level 3, right? Actually, you're still very successful.
那是什么呢?
What is that?
就是能同理对方的感受.
This one is I can empathize with the other person's feelings.
你很多时候为什么他们吵吵闹闹，他们不甘心，他们苦读，是因为你没有感受到我感受什么。你只会用一般的理性来去跟我解决问题，来告诉我你，你看你怎么要这样，你不需要这样的，有这种感受， stupid are you?
So a lot of times, right, we don't listen to empathize and all that. You know, we try to problem solve. We use a lot of logic to try to solve their problem. Yeah, why you do this again? I already told you many times. You stupid are you? You know, because their feelings are not being heard. That's why they're nagging.
当我们每一个人，其实我们每一个人都要我们别人能够同理，能够理解我的感受。先不要讲理解我的感受，你已经帮了我一半了。
So let me tell you, I'm not a lot of most of us, every one of us, right? We are not looking for problems to be solved using logic or whatever. But if you can understand what I am feeling at the moment, 50% of it is already solved.
你今天要怎么去积极的去谋杀你的关系
？So today, what are the ways are you unintentionally or intentionally using to murder your relationship?
继续不要听啊。
Continuously, just do it. Continue.
你继续忽视他。
Keep on, you know, doing that.
有一天,
one day,
without you realizing, 有一天当你不自觉的时候，他突然，你的另一半已经是你要面对的是他冷漠的背影。
So one day, before you realize it, you realize that you're not facing them, you're facing their cold, apathetic back.
你以为一切还很好。
At first you thought it was all actually good.
到最后可能你要承受的就是他要跟你说离婚。But
in the end, you might have to accept that they are calling for a divorce.
要积极的去谋杀你的关系吗? 不要聆听吧。
If you want to
冷落他吧, 觉得他烦吧。
If you want to continue murdering a relationship, don't listen to them. Disregard their feelings and ignore them.
这是你要做的选择。
This is a decision that can only be done by you.
你知道圣经中他说什么？但你们个人要什么？一起读，快快的，慢慢的，慢慢的。啊，我们常常很喜欢倒反过来，快快的动怒，快快的说，慢慢的听。我们倒反的哦，很奇怪啊。So
sometimes we are all we got it the other way around. Swift to argue, swift to speak, slow to listen.
最后，一个不会游泳的人老是换泳池是解决不到问题的。 一个不会经营爱情的人，老是换伴侣，也是解决不了问题的。
A person who cannot swim and keeps changing pools cannot solve the problem. Likewise, a person who cannot manage love and keeps changing partners also cannot solve the problem.
所以盼望。
So I hope.
盼望我们今天能够学到这一招，就是聆听。
That we can learn.
去practice一万次。
We can learn this skill of active listening. Practicing it a million times.
最后，除了讲爱情之外，我也想讲最后一句，用这一个哈 ，inspired by 这句话，就是一个不会经营关系的人，老是换教会也解决不了问题的。要鼓掌就鼓他。一个不会经营关系的人，老是换教会也是解决不了问题的。
So then, let me put this into perspective again. If a person who doesn't know how to manage relationships will continuously change churches, but still can't solve the problem.
Amen. 让我们一起站立，让我们决定说，主啊，让我好好学会聆听。聆听是一个谦卑的表现，先放下自己的益处，先去听别人。Let
us rise and let us all remember today that listening, active listening, is an act of humility, of putting ourselves aside.
拍拍你身边的伴侣，跟他说，聆听我啊。
And not to the person next to you, tell them, listen to me.
你看，全部没有学到功课，没有学到功课。
Nobody is doing anything. Nobody has learned the homework.
你应该说的不是聆听我，要跟他说什么？我会聆听你，我在试你们而已。
You should have said that. I will listen to you. Nobody learned anything today. Should tell them I will listen to you.
好，这时候让我们一起来祷告，好不好？来，我们一起祷告，牵着你身边人的手，我们一起来祷告。Let's
all hold, you know, the hands of the person next to us. Let's pray.
亲爱的主耶稣。
The Lord Jesus.
我们感谢你。
We thank you.
因为你为我们做了榜样。
Because you have set a great example for us.
你先走下来人间，你先来了解我们。
You first walk in the midst of the people that you created and walk among us to understand us, to empathize.
你也先为我们死。
You have also died for us.
主啊，之后你才呼召我们跟随你。
And then you have only then you have called us to follow you.
今天我们把我们整个教会的那些有婚姻的。
So today we surrender to you all those in the church that have marriages.
有爱情的。
They have love.
所以我们祈求你，让我们能够今天的眼睛被打开，看到主，我们要学习放下自己。先去聆听。
And that today we open our eyes, denying putting aside ourselves and learning how to love.
主啊，我们学习聆听之后，主啊，我们相信有很多的事情已经，我们关系上的问题已经会解决一大半。
Because when we learn to listen, Lord, most of the problems that occur in our relationships all tend to solve themselves one by one.
求你保守我们的心智，提醒我们，让我们能够有决心的学会这一招聆听。
Guard our hearts and continually remind us with your Holy Spirit that we need to learn how to listen.
主啊，让教会的所有有婚姻有家庭的，主啊，都成为一个蒙福的家庭和婚姻。
And I pray, Lord, that all those who have families in the church will have wonderful and happy families.
让教会能够站在这个破碎的世代，用这个家庭美满还有美满的这个婚姻，成为明亮的灯台。
That the church may play its distinct role as a salt and a light to relationships in today's world.
我们这样的祈求祷告。
We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ.
奉耶稣基督得胜的名。
In Jesus Christ.
我们一起说，阿门。荣耀的掌声归给我们的神。